Well, let's head to another story now. An exclusive in News Corp papers today reveals the story of a Melbourne man who bought a town in the middle of California with an aspiring vision. Well, joining me live from New York is Tom Minert, News Corp US correspondent. Hello to you, Tom. Now, this is a very exciting story here, an exclusive that you've uncovered. So tell us all about it.
Yeah, it's a really fascinating story. So Ross Mollison is from Melbourne. He lived in Melbourne for a long time and was a theatre producer and moved to the States sort of in the early 2000s. And he's been running a company called Spiegelworld, which people might know. Some of their shows have toured back in Australia, but mostly in Las Vegas. They run three shows. They're quite a big deal. And yeah, recently there'd been a town for sale called Nipton, which is about an hour's drive from Vegas in the Mojave Desert. And Ross and his team got wind of it. It was a woman trying to sell it. Her husband had bought the town back in the 1980s. He had sadly passed away and she was ready to get rid of it. It was originally sold to a cannabis company, which was a bit weird. They were trying to set up some kind of resort for influencers to come and spruik weed products. That didn't quite work out. They stopped paying her. She went to try and find another buyer. And that was when Ross and Spiegelworld decided we're going to buy it and turn it into a circus town. So, yeah, went out there a couple of weeks ago to have a visit and look around. And it's a really fascinating place. And, yeah, quite a unique story.
It certainly is. And we just saw some vision there of Nipton. You said it's an hour away from Las Vegas, where, again, the Spiegelworld has so many shows. So a great location. I mean, who would have thought, like, just buying a whole area? It's just incredible.
Yeah, and I feel like it's a bit hard for us in Australia to get our heads around. You know, we're used to small towns in regional areas being run by local councils and things like that, whereas in the US, this is a little bit more common. You know, people can take ownership of a town, and I think this is about 80 acres, Nipton. So, yeah, Ross and his team are basically in charge of the utilities. They've got to make sure the water's running. They're trying to turn it into a sort of fully solar-powered area. Technically, they kind of keep an eye on law enforcement, but they had too many troubles. But yeah, so it is quite strange. It's a bit different compared to what we're used to in Australia, but it gives them a lot of flexibility to kind of run the place how they want to and set it up for this vision of a circus town and a headquarters for the Spiegelworld company.
And Tom, you write in your article that Australia's theatre industry has turned into a boring Broadway replica. That's what I believe Ross had put. Tell us what's happening here.
Yeah, it was a really interesting view from Ross. So he worked in Australia in the late 90s, early 2000s as a theatre producer, did some pretty big things. He took Cats in a big top show all around the country that played at all the roos. So, like, he knows the industry quite well. He's been in the US a long time, though, and he essentially was saying that his view of Australia now is that it's a bit of a Broadway knockoff, that all the producers basically just go and buy shows from the US and bring them over. And I mean, obviously, they're incredibly popular. You know, Harry Potter, Moulin Rouge, Hamilton, all these shows do really well in Melbourne and Sydney. But I think his message is more around that it would be great to see a bit more Australian creativity and Australian stories on stage. He, back in the day, pioneered Puppetry of the Penis, which was a very, you know, hilarious show that everyone got really into in the late 90s. And he then took that over the world and took that to the US and it was quite popular. So, yeah, and it's interesting. I mean, he has been based in the US during COVID, but is hoping to spend a bit more time back home in Australia and kind of spoke a bit to me about wanting to invest again in the Australian industry and bring some more Australian stories back on stage.
Well, I tell you what, by his history, his CV and his enthusiasm, it sounds like he's going to do it, doesn't it? I mean, he's just very enthusiastic and inspiring.
Yeah, you've got to be pretty entrepreneurial to be to be doing what he's done. And yeah, I mean, Spiegelworld, for people that don't know too much about it, has become a huge company in Vegas. They've got about 700 staff. So they're a pretty big deal. One of their shows runs, you know, every night of the year outside Caesar's Palace. So they're a real institution and it's a great Aussie success story. And yeah, I think Ross would be keen to kind of work a bit more back home and show off kind of what he's achieved back in Australia as well.
Well, well done on the article. It's a great read. And if anyone wants to read it, they can hop onto their website and, you know, News Corp websites and also in the News Corp papers today. But it's great to speak to you live in New York. Tom Minert, we'll talk to you again soon.
Thanks for having me.